OTS Tech Zone. We're working on building some lights. I think I got some things set up there, ready to go. Get some wheel over there and pull up the chat. Very well, eh? Well, I kind of was mumbling. Let's see. Turn that up. Oh, and it's also picking it up off of this cam right here. It says workbench mic. That doesn't. Let's just make sure. Yeah, it is this cam. So, let's just switch that. Properties. Bet you can hear me a little better now. Let me know if that's true, because now it should be getting it from this camera right there. But I do like the idea of a headset. It is not a bad idea, but for now I kind of like not having anything on my head, and also I like these omnidirectional mics that can pick up sound a little bit better. But yeah, thanks for letting me know about that, because that's good. Switched it around. I don't know why it was set wrong, but got it. Okay, so let's get into things. Pull out some tape and some scissors. Then get these things ready. This is the last one I think that I gotta do.
teeth, really, I could just take all the waterproof layer off. But I guess I'm not going to right now. Okay. So, start by sticking them down. I guess I'll make this one go clockwise. Because why not? So it's basically there to there. Removes the adhesive. That. And then there's an arrow on here. You probably can't see it on there. But there's an arrow on there. And it indicates the direction that this flows. You probably couldn't see that because there wasn't enough light up there. But we'll see. Okay, so basically, I just stick it down and hope it sticks down. So this is a 3D printed surface. I don't know how well it's gonna adhere to it. It's just kind of a rough 3D printed surface too, but it seemed to do it pretty well. And then next one to here. Make sure I put the arrow going the right direction. We always want to just flow with the arrows. And just get this off. Yeah, the workspace is pretty awesome, Andrew. You should come check it out sometime. Would love to have you over. And it would be cool to collaborate on some things and stuff. I still want to build a lightsaber someday, but all in perfect timing, right? Okay, that's pretty good. I could have been a bit more that way. I could have been a bit more that way, but that'll work. And it's the next one. I realize I can't see because of this. I could have my camera closer. It could be higher res, but I can't actually get even higher res on Facebook Live, so it's a limitation there. Fingernails. So, direction flow check, going good. So far so good. And then I want to continue the flow going this way. I want it to go from point to point, end to end. That's all stuck down. And that's good to go. So, the next step is to solder it all together. Now I could have pre-tinned all of these before I stuck them down, that would have been smart, but we can still do it after the fact. In fact, it may actually be better after the fact, because that way we only have to tape them down once. So I just need six little pieces of, well, could just use one and then move it. Let's do that. See how well that works. Oh, Michael. And my ma. Cool. Yeah. Sorry I didn't link up with you while I was in Silverton there. I'm going to be back soon. I'm thinking tomorrow. If you still want to link up. Okay, so let the pre-tinning begin. It would be good to have it all set up. Just pre-tin them all. So let's just do that. So if you can hear some music in the background, you're witnessing some creations of some very talented roommates that I have. Okay. And Let's do these three and untape them and do the other three. I don't know why, but. Doing that, I can grab this tool because I'm going to need it. And let's just take a big section that we're going to. Okay, so heat it up. And pretend there's some leads. Back. So it was pretty cool to have the opportunity to use a 3D printer. Print something out. It will be cool to make it into a light. Because even though it's not perfect, it will do. Yeah, I look forward to using the 3D printer again, some other designs, but what I'm really looking forward to is using a CNC machine, CNC cutting machine, which I actually met somebody who's got one, and it may be possible that I can use it at some point, maybe a work exchange or something, so I'm stoked on that. Could have done this before, but this is not good. So now, got this all stripped, and then just twist it all together. Thank you.
Yeah, next time.
I'll do that at the start. It's kind of like out there. It's like, hey, just copy and paste it, so it's really quick. But for now, that worked. So, what is up next? We pretend this. Could just wrap it. See what happens there. Let it heat. This, we do the connections. So basically, we want to connect the inside ones first and move our way out. Let's do that. The DO to DI will be next. Thank you.
How on ya?
Welcome. Thanks for that thingy here. We haven't used the vinyl cutter thingy yet, but you'll have to come by sometime and use it. We'll have to get some vinyl to cut, I guess. Yeah. But yes. Hearts. Aw. Aw, love to you too, Tonya. Hearts. What a magical day it was in Caslo, eh? Today it was magical in Caslo. Us Caslo people know. There were sun showers, and it was beautiful. Yes, we're lucky here. Very lucky. I like it. So, this connection. Ground. And this one. Good. We kind of pulled the one edge up a bit, but that's okay, I think. Just put this down. Okay. And that is one. No bridges, not perfect, but it will work. So then we just have one more. And we almost will have a light built, so we can test after three more connections here. Three there, but see,
check the time, see how fast we can do this. 2016,
so it's 8:16 right now. I'm guessing I will have this done before 8:30, but maybe even much before. I think, yeah, maybe 5 minutes. That would be fast. Oops. Soldering. So apparently, it really matters to do the prep. This one more time, and then there's one last texture. So fun having like live hip hop freestyles. Again. Yeah. strip it without cutting it, but cut it anyways. Strip it. Pretty well. To wrap it. Cool. So, take that off. Put it back on one more time. Once we do this, then it's just the connector and test. Which is fun. Connect the 5 volt on the ground here, but since it's such a small amount of light, we don't really need to. So let's just do this connection. 5 volt DI and ground. And I could use a pair of tweezers for this part. Let's try these ones. Start with the inside one and work my way up. Okay. Let it heat up, pre-tin and tip. Already done, but pre-tin it, start fresh. Okay. Put this in there, in the slot, and then start with the red. Put that little thing down. Five volts and then DI. And it's kind of, I almost need to pull the red out just a bit so it can fit. Go. And then I could have trimmed it so that the ground one was a little shorter. Just could have made the whole lead a little shorter, but I think this will work. And with that, takes the tape off. I'll check the work too. No. Close. No bridges. Good. I can see with the naked eye too. Good. Nice. Good. Nice. And this will be a moment of truth. If I plug it into the controller, will it work? This we do not know until we do so. And I'm gonna find Z. I think I'm gonna do a power supply. Suppose I can unplug the power supply from that. It's nice to have a fresh one. It is, so let's temporarily unplug this one and this thing and this thing. So plug this right here. This and here, and we should see the lights come on. 5 volts, 5 volt diode, DI, and ground. Arrows are going the right way. Okay, hopefully it works.
Yeah, that triangle is in work, good working order. Mushroom picking. I don't know. Maybe. I've never gone mushroom picking before. But I might be interested. We could chat about this later. And yes, Andrew, the triangle that I got back is in good working order. And here it is. Right there. Is this one? Yes. Yeah, thanks for keeping it in safe for me while you had it, and this thing's actually proven to be pretty durable. It's survived quite a few drop tests so far, so that's good. And, I'm stoked to have it back. That was a fun story for sure. Thank you for holding it. But, yes, and this triangle that we created seems to work. Is it a little itty bitty one? And I'm thinking this one actually could even be powered from USB because doesn't have too many lights. So I kinda wanna try that. I have a cable
that should be able to do it.
Right, y'all. And we'll test it out. See if it works off of USB. And USB on a computer as well. So just plug it into USB on the computer. Show you the cable connector, and then I think, yeah, you can see the USB port on the side. Plug into side of computer, and then plug into light, and hopefully it power on. And it does! And so that's running off of the USB on the computer. Excelente! Excelente, muy bien! Cool. Well, that's pretty cool. USB powered light. That's fun. People might like that. And it's 3D printed. And that's kind of fun too. And maybe, I don't know if I've already, no, I haven't released this one online. So I can release the source, or the KiCad, or pardon me, FreeCAD files and the STL files
needed to print this light. And it could also be cut from a CNC machine as well. So, yeah, hopefully tonight I'll release those online. If I don't do that tonight and you want these files and you're like, where do I get them? Blah, blah, blah. Yeah, let me know, because sometimes I need some encouragement. I hope to get it done tonight. So yeah, that's this little tiny triangle, and it's got a total of 2, 4, 6 times 3 is 18 lights. So this is a Technicolor Triangle 18 with a RF LED Dream Color controller. Can be controlled.
One of these little controllers.
Can change. It's supposed to be one of these. Yes, maybe not. I don't know. I wonder if it's a power issue. Let's try it. This one. Let's just go. Oh yeah. Cool. And that's pretty neat. It's kind of neat that it just has a cool edge glow even just on the counter like that. That's like, that's about the height that would be good. Huh? Yeah, much further. Gets washed out. Kind of like that. So it'd be good to have just little spacers or something to hold it. Like that. It's kind of cool like that. But yes, very good, very good. And at that, I think I might take snack break, and I may be back later tonight. For those of you who have tuned in, thank you for tuning in. And yeah, if you're interested in these lights and what I'm building, hit me up. I've got some for sale, different varieties, like the triangle lights, and then the hexagon lights, and I have made battery-powered versions of this triangle light and the record light, but I don't have any for sale just yet. I'm not going to sell the prototypes, but if you would like one of the battery-powered versions, which are super fun, they last all night and can be controlled from phones, so they're kind of cool. If you would like a battery-powered version, let me know, and I will be building more in the future, but if you let me know, it may encourage me to build them sooner, hopefully. I think it's a matter of getting all the parts together and everything, and also I'd like to have them CNC cut, but yeah, I could also cut them by hand like I did with this one. But yeah. Post it online for sale anywhere. Yeah, I posted on my Facebook account that they were for sale, but other than that, I don't have any posted online for sale just yet. I don't have too many built to sell. I've got, well, 4 triangles here. That little one, which I don't think I'm going to sell because it's a one of a kind. And then I've got a hexagon up on the wall over there, so completed. And then there's another hexagon in the works. So yeah, I definitely should list them online. I think I'm going to list them on Etsy and also on my website. So yeah, maybe that could be a project that I do for tonight or something. That's a very good question. Thank you, Andrew. And yeah, that's encouragement to list them online for sale again. And this time in a place where they kind of stay permanent and people from all over the world and not just people on my Facebook account will see them, which is, I think, will be kind of key for selling these things. But, anywho, at that, I think I am going to bid you guys adieu. Thank you for tuning in, And if you like the videos and want to see more and encourage more video production and live streaming, you could always support me on Patreon. Open to source on Patreon. Otherwise, just let me know that you dig. Like, comment, share. And yeah, have a good night. Ciao for now.